The second claim was that the SAS at Campbell Barracks were infested with Israeli troops, lecturers, professors, communication specialists crawling all over the bases. These were the claims made by Brendan O'Connell. We start our research with a phone call to the Defense Department. So I decided to call them up, give them a call, find out, ask them firsthand, get some information live and direct 24 hours a day online to see what we can find.
Welcome to the Defense Switchboard. The next available operator will assist with your inquiry. This call will be recorded for quality, training, and security purposes.
Thank you for waiting. How may I help you?
Yes, very good afternoon, ma'am. I'm just doing a report online. I was hoping you'd assist me with some information. Can you tell me, is it feasible that the Israeli army are doing operations with Australia at the Campbell Barracks in WA?
Put you through to the media.
Thank you, ma'am.
Defence Media, Kyle speaking.
Yes, a very good afternoon, Kyle. How are you, sir?
Pretty good, thanks. What can I do for you?
Fantastic. My name's Steve Johnson. I'm calling on behalf of SoutheastAsianNews.org, just doing a bit of background research for an article. Can you tell me, is it feasible to assume that the Israeli army are doing operations with the Australian SAS elite at the Campbell Barracks in WA?
Oh, okay. Not sure. What you'll have to do, because the ADF's so big, I'd have to facilitate this through probably army. Am I able to get you to email me your inquiry, which I can then forward on to army for their consideration? I'd be more informed about it.
Yes, sir.
Get a response back to you through that way.
For sure. That'd be great.
What type of deadline were you looking at for this, Steve?
Approximately a week on this one.
Okay, no worries. Well, we should be able to get it back to you before then, but what I'll get you to do is forward through your inquiry to our media operations team's email address. That's
yes.
at defence.gov.au, defence spelt with a C. If you can flag that attention to Kyle in the subject line, it'll come through to me.
Fantastic. Well, what I'm after, sir, I'm not after any specific information or anything that's going to violate national security or anything.
No worries.
Just a yes or no if the Israelis are training with Australian SAS troops in Campbell Barracks, that's all.
Sure thing.
There's been a lot of online speculation about this, and I'd like to clear this up for a lot of people.
Okay, too easy, Steve. Well, we'll see if we can get that back for you before too long.
Fantastic. Thanks for your help, Kyle.
Cheers, thank you.
Bye now.
Bye.
Gee, not bad for an Aussie, that's for sure. These were the questions that I prompted him via email. Can I please get a basic confirmation that any Israelis, either civilian contractors or military, are training, teaching, or otherwise lecturing in any way at Campbell Barracks in Western Australia? And so on, and so on, and so on. A full transcript of all these questions can be found in the information box at the top of this video. Well, I finally heard back from Defense Media Ops, and every question a resounding no. According to the Defense Department, there were no Israelis at the SAS Campbell Barracks, teaching or in otherwise any other capacity. So that was it. Or was it? I went to another source and asked a question to this eyewitness to Brendan O'Connell's hearing, and here's the result. Thanks very much for joining us. We won't say your real name, but you're Mr. Nexus, are you, sir?
Yes, that's right.
And I believe you were present at the time that Brendan O'Connell was remanded, is that correct?
I was at the beginning of the court case, yes. He was remanded over at the time because of a lack of information regarding bail conditions by the prosecution, and I didn't end up staying on till the end of the case thereafter.
Okay. So let me get this clear. Basically, he was remanded because they had no information further to the charges, is that correct?
The magistrate was questioning some of the conditions regarding his charges, regarding the bail. One of those conditions, for example, was that he was not to come within a certain distance of Campbell Barracks, and the magistrate was questioning the purpose of those bail conditions. There were a number of quite onerous conditions like that. The prosecution was not able to provide any information as to those bail conditions, which is why he was remanded over in custody temporarily until they were able to find that information. Knowing the system, I knew it could take a number of more hours, so I, having left my information with Brendan, backed out of the courtroom and came home, basically.
Okay, because my questions to the Defense Department, I've got an answer back from their media division. When I asked them very specifically, has there been any complaints or has there been any Israeli taught activity at Campbell Barracks? They come back a resounding no. Does that fall in line with what you heard from the magistrate there?
Not exactly. There was definite talk of Israeli personnel at Campbell Barracks and involved with training of our SAS personnel, I believe was the wording at the time. There was talk of such. There was some knowledge of it by the prosecution. They gave a little bit of information towards it, but not the details that the magistrate was seeking, that was all.
So you're saying this a court magistrate in a petty sessions court openly said the names of Israeli Mossad agents at Campbell Barracks?
No, excuse me if it seemed I was saying that. No, it was Brendan who made the mention of those names.
In the court proceedings?
Yes, he was trying to explain the conditions himself to the court. And in so doing, he volunteered information regarding Israeli agents here, apparently.
Uh-huh.
I believe it was some information he had also reported via his videos. As I understand, that was some of the, that was some of what it was about. He had been making videos about the Campbell Barracks and the comings and goings there.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah.
Because I didn't think anybody's seen those online. Since that day, have you noticed that anything's happened to you in particular since the court date?
Not particularly. I actually had a visit from the same department of the police about a week before Brendan on the basis of some anonymous complaint that I might be a concern to the chosen ones. So I was subjected to an investigation and questioning about roughly a week before Brendan was arrested.
Oh my God.
So actually, that's why I took an interest in the case, because it became, it was obvious to me when it happened that basically it was very close to what had happened to me, that it was a bit of a case of there but for the grace of God go I kind of thing, you know?
To hear the finish of this interview, please click part 3.